Joining me now from Toronto, former Prime Minister Brian Mulroney. So, Mr. Mulroney, what sense do you get from the President, given you were just sitting with him the other day, about what he would like the Canada-U.S. relationship to look like?
Well, I think basically what he said publicly at the end of Mr. Trudeau's visit, that he viewed the relationship with Canada in a very friendly manner, a very successful relationship. And when Mr. Trudeau quoted Churchill 77 years ago at the end of his own speech, you may have noticed that Mr. Trump picked up right on it immediately and looked at Prime Minister Trudeau and smiled in agreement with it. When Churchill described ours as the relationship as a model for all mankind. So I think we've got a good situation going. I think he told me that Mr. Trump mentioned that Justin had, Prime Minister Trudeau had a very successful trip down there, and he was engaged with him personally and spent a lot of time with him and enjoyed his company a great deal. That's what he told me.
And when the President talked then at that press conference about tweaking NAFTA, how did you interpret that?
I interpreted it as a signal that while we're going to negotiate to modernize NAFTA, the Canadian part of it is in pretty good shape, even though it can do with some modernization. After all, it's 25 years old. And when I negotiated that with Ronald Reagan, smartphones didn't even exist, and the internet was in a very embryonic phase. And so I interpreted that to say we want some changes, but this is not a worrisome procedure for them or for us. On the other hand, he indicated a much stronger position with regard to Mexico, and he called it, I think, much more severe. So, but I think the negotiations will go on with us and with the Mexicans, and they'll be ultimately resolved.
When you were speaking earlier today about how you have the impression that the President thinks a lot of the problems that his country has encountered are because of NAFTA, when really they're not, have you had that conversation with him? Is there anyone making that case to him that it's actually mostly automation, modernization of technology that's led to job loss and not trade?
Well, I made that case not only to him, but to many of his most senior advisors and now cabinet ministers. Eventually, I think there will be a modification in their thinking when a lot of these political realities sink in. You know, Rosie, Mario Cuomo once said that you campaign in poetry, but you govern in prose. And I think the reality of governing is going to dawn on this administration as it dawns on all of us. And what we say in campaigns is not, we find when we're in office, is not as easy or as quick or as obvious as we thought. And there's a lot of compromise and changing of positions and so on to get from point A to B. And I think there'd be a fair amount of that in this as well.
You also said today that you don't think that what the President is considering for NAFTA is lethal for Mexico. And I know you're also talking to Mexican officials there today. Do you still believe that Canada should keep Mexico as part of NAFTA conversations? Or is there a point in time which we should just cut ties and worry about our bilateral relationship?
Well, obviously the obligation of the Prime Minister is to protect Canada's interests above and everything else. But that's not an absolute, totally absolute position. Throwing friends and neighbors and allies under the bus is a position for a weak leader. This is not the traditional Canadian strong position on anything. And so I don't envisage this government throwing an ally like Mexico under the bus. Now, what could change that equation is that if President Trump and his colleagues articulated a new American policy in which they said, henceforth, we will only conclude bilateral trade arrangements, no more multilateral or trilateral arrangements. Well, that would be a new reality. And we would have to then look at that in the light of the articulation of this new policy. We're not there yet.
You've said that you do believe, in spite of perhaps some of the mistakes the administration has made in this first month, that you still believe the president can accomplish great things. What could Canada do to try and take advantage of some of those great things that he might be able to accomplish?
I think they're in the process of doing it with on infrastructure, defense, the upgrading of NORAD, for example. Look, what we have going for us is that we fought with alongside the Americans in World War I, World War II, in Korea. We're members of the G7 together. We're members of the G20 and so on. And we have the largest bilateral trading relationship in the history of the world, with millions and millions of jobs on both sides of the border depending on it. Moreover, we have a history of friendship where a shot has not been fired across this border in over 200 years. This is remarkable. This is, as Churchill said in that statement 77 years ago, this relationship is an example to all mankind and a model for the future of the world. Well, nothing wrong with that. And so we should be looking for ways to enhance that. And as we do that, the Americans will more and more appreciate the importance of Canada to their success and the perception of them in the world. I once told President Reagan and President Bush, look, if you can't get along with Canada, you don't have a problem just with dear old Canada, you've got a problem with the world. How the hell are you going to explain to reasonable people in Europe and elsewhere that you do not have a friendly relationship with your best friend and neighbor? What's going on? And so I think that Mr. Trudeau and his colleagues, and I was told, by the way, that they got the senior staff from Canada got along very well with the White House staff. This is all money in the bank for us, and we have to use it to strengthen our bilateral relationship and to take advantage of every opening until all of a sudden things settle down a year or so from now and President Trump realizes what a great friend and ally Canada really is.
Okay, Mr. Mulroney, we'll leave it there. Thank you for your time, sir.
Thank you.